Hey guys, it's Mrs. Parsley. I'm going to show you a little video on how to make shadows on a paper and then trace them to create an art project out of it. So I have a couple things. I have set up a couple pieces of paper down here, and I have a rock holding them because the breeze keeps blowing and trying to blow them away every once in a while. I have a toy dinosaur that I found. Thought he was pretty cool and be fun to trace his shadow. And then I have even a little pig that I found. So I just tried to find a couple things that I might want to trace. So on your paper, you can kind of play around with it on the ground and see where you should place your figure or animal. It doesn't have to be an animal. It could be whatever you want. And I'm going to place it on the ground. My rock is just to hold my paper still. And then I can place my little pig wherever on the paper that I want to trace his shadow. Once I have him ready, then I will take a marker. You can use pencil too. And I'm going to trace his shadow. Now, obviously, the sun has to be out for this. And at different times of day, it will look differently depending on where the sun is in the sky. Okay, so now I have my dinosaur, and I'm going to set him up real quick. And since he's really large, it's hard to get his whole shadow on my paper, the size of paper that I have. But I think it would be neat to just do his face. Now, if I place him right in front of my paper, that kind of works, but I don't like it that his arm is connected. It looks like it's connected to his face. So I figured out what I can do to make it look a little bit further away, up here further away. I have a little chair that I'm using, and I'm gonna prop it up and kind of arrange my dinosaur so that he fits better on my paper and then I can get whatever view it is that I'm looking for a shadow. And this is kind of just a trial and error, see what you can come up with, make it fun, a little bit of science in art. Ooh, I really like that, if I can get him to stand. So, once I have him propped up, I'm going to trace that shadow and you'll see what that looks like. Hold on. That's better. I don't really love it still. So, that's kind of fun. Okay, so I'm gonna trace that shadow real quick. Okay, so I have brought my picture inside and I have set up my supplies so that I can add details to what was my dinosaur's shadow. I am actually gonna try and copy what my dinosaur looks like here. You can be as creative as you want. If you want an animal that looks like a rainbow, even though yours wasn't, that is perfectly fine. This is your time to make this your art project. So I'm gonna go along with some of the details that I see on this dinosaur because I do like all the different colors that you can see in him. I like how I think I can show some texture, so showing how he feels. And then I'm going to add a background and other things into the picture to make that the more creative side of it. Let's see. So let me try and angle this guy where y'all can see him. First, I'm going to start out with his eye and do a couple things to make it look more like a Tyrannosaurus Rex. So you can do this in pencil, crayon, marker, any supply that you may have at home. So now you can see me adding details. Notice that I'm using lots of colors. If you have the ability to use several shades of green, then do that. That's what's going to make your project look more interesting and even more realistic. I did lots of little dots everywhere to show the texture of the bumpiness of the Tyrannosaurus Rex skin, and lots of different shades of green, like I said. Now my picture is ready to have any kind of background added to it. And this is where the fun really, really starts, and you can make your picture as silly or realistic as you want. I'm considering doing a Jurassic Park looking background. Who knows, maybe my Tyrannosaurus Rex is chasing a person or an animal. We'll see what we come up with. Let me know if you have any ideas, and maybe I'll add it into my picture and show you guys the final project later. Now it's your turn to go outside and create your art project. Be creative, enjoy that sunshine that we are expected to have for the rest of the week. I hope you guys are doing great.